Hi there, my name's Jared Broad, and in this bootcamp tutorial, we're going to be looking into the fading the gap strategy. This strategy monitors the market for gaps that occurred overnight, and then bets in the opposite direction, assuming that the market will mean revert. Here, we're going to use scheduled events to set up the scaffolding for our algorithm, and then we're going to use a rolling window to calculate the price changes which occurred overnight. We're then going to use a standard deviation indicator to try and eliminate a parameter in our algorithm. So, let's get started. First, we're going to use scheduled events to save the opening and closing prices for our algorithm. Here, we're going to use some time rules that we haven't previously seen. These are after market open and before market close. As you'd expect, these trigger the scheduled event after the market opens and a few minutes before the market closes. If you pass in zero here, it'll trigger the scheduled event at exactly 4 o'clock on a traditional equities day. So the first thing we need to do is create a scheduled event to run 0 minutes before the market closes, or as the market closes at 4 p.m. So we can copy this code here. And we want to run this every day before the market closes. And then we need to pass in the event handler that we want to use. And we're going to call an event handler here, closing bar. So let's create that method. And while we're here, let's create the other methods, which are right here. Finally, another method here, close positions. Okay, now we need another scheduled event to run every day 1 minute after the market opens. At 9:30 exactly, we don't have the full minute bar, so we need to wait for at least 1 minute to get that opening price. So let's create a new scheduled event. Want to run after market open, 1 minute. And we want to call the opening bar event handler. Okay. Now finally, we don't quite have the trading logic yet, but here we're going to make sure that we close out our positions 45 minutes after the market opens, no matter what. So let's reuse a lot of this code here. We want to do it 45 minutes later, and we want to call close positions. And then finally here, we need to liquidate our position. Now we're only trading Tesla, so we don't really need to pass in the symbol here, but it's always good to be safe. So now we're going to call close positions 45 minutes after market open every single day. Okay, let's see how we go. Okay, great. On to the next task. Here we're going to create a rolling window. The rolling window will be used to save the price of yesterday and the price of today so that we can calculate the price movement overnight. And this will be the foundation of the gap calculation that we do later. So a rolling window is the kind of an opposite of an array. An array, when you add items, get added onto the bottom. The oldest item is at position 0, and then as you add new items, they increase in the index. Rolling windows have an inverted index, so the newest item is always at position 0, and the older items get shuffled back over time. This can help for this sort of situation where we want to just work with a few values, and we can access those values easily with our rolling window. So let's first create our rolling window. Rolling windows can be of any type. They can hold any sort of data that you want, except you just need to remember you need to define the data that you want to save here. In this case, we want a length 2 rolling window. So remember this is a 0 indexed array, so that means that there will be data at positions 0 and 1, and those two numbers will be our window. The next part says to add the current trade bar of Tesla to our rolling window. So with a scheduled event, you don't always have easy access to price data that occurred in the onData method. To make that easier, Lean has created a current slice property in your algorithm. So you can see here, we've got self.rollingWindow.add, and we can just add in the current slice for Tesla to our rolling window. And number three, let's do exactly the same thing, but for the opening bar. Okay, let's see how it goes. Okay, great. Next, we're going to use our rolling window to get the price movement that happened overnight. So just like an indicator, the rolling window has the isReady property to tell you when the window is full. So with our example, it's fairly easy because we've only got two values. But imagine you've got 100 items in your window. You want to make sure that the window is completely full of data before you start doing any sort of math on it. So we can use this if not window ready, then return to control when we do our trading. And now we will never reach this part of the code until we have a full rolling window. So let's calculate the price delta that happened overnight. If you remember, the rolling window position 0 has the most recent trade bar. So this is the bar we've just added up here, and this would be the opening bar. So we want to make sure we get the opening price for that bar. And then secondly, we want to take the close of yesterday to find our opening range from the close at 4 p.m. to the opening price at 9:30. So now we have an accurate delta. Let's decide when to trade. So you can see here we're going to say if the delta is less than negative $10, then set holdings to 100% Tesla. So if delta is minus 10, so negative 10 is a fairly arbitrary number, but for the sake of this demonstration, we're using this to decide when to trade. But of course, in production, you would never want to use such an arbitrary parameter in your algorithm. Okay, great. On to the next task. Okay, so now we've got our algorithm trading, but we're using the negative 10 value as a parameter. One way that we could eliminate this is to look at the deviation of the gaps to see if they're normal and if it's within an expected range. If it goes outside of that expected range, that could be a good signal for us to trade. So to do that, we could use the standard deviation indicator to monitor the volatility and see if our jumps, our overnight gaps, are outside of that range. To do that, we're going to use a manual indicator. Manual indicators under the hood are very similar to normal indicators, except you need to update them with price data manually. So you can see here, there's a manual indicator for every automatic helper, but it's just the full spelling of the indicator's name. It takes the name and the period, just like a normal indicator. So first, let's create our standard deviation object for Tesla, and we want to create it with a 60-minute period. So if you note here, this is 60 periods, but it doesn't necessarily know the resolution of the data because we pump it with data. So it has no idea of its resolution. We control this indicator totally. So next, we're going to update that indicator with some data. The update method takes two arguments, the time and the value you'd like to update. So in this case, we're going to pass in the close of Tesla. So here we're going to have a standard deviation indicator that represents the last 60 minutes of the trading day from yesterday. Now, point number three, let's check if our indicator is ready before we use it. This is always a good thing to do. So if not ready, then let's return. Okay, great. So now we're pretty sure that our indicator is created, it's being updated, and now it's ready to use. Now we can use that indicator to figure out how many standard deviations the overnight gap represents. Standard deviations typically range from negative 3 to positive 3, And when the standard deviations are more than negative 3, it has less than 1% chance of occurring. So we can use this for our trading. So let's calculate the number of standard deviations that this price delta represents. So we can take the price delta divided by that standard deviation value. Okay. And when that is more than negative 3, then we trade. Let's see how we go. So far, so good. Okay, great. Congratulations, you've passed the Fading the Gap bootcamp tutorial. In this tutorial, you've learned about manual indicators, scheduling after market open and before market close, and using the current slice property of your algorithm. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.